Phrasing is ability to distribute weight and energy while playing. It helps to breathe in and breathe out while playing. Not to play just on breathe in on inhalation when we play without weight, or play with constant exhalation when we play with the same level of weight, but always moving with the waves. And this helps to bring freedom to our muscles and natural flow to our music. Phrasing consists of small blocks motifs that united to bigger blocks phrases that united to bigger blocks sentences. And each of these blocks have their combination parts, motifs, and their own main intervals, phrases, main motifs, and sentences, main phrases. We're going to practice through singing and playing how to make energetic crescendo, because this is what phrasing is all about. An energetic crescendo has nothing to do with dynamical crescendo. We can increase energy with decreasing volume. For example, in this motif, we're going to this interval. And we can do this with diminuendo. This kind of intonation was very popular back in the beginning of 20th century, like when Rachmaninoff was playing Horowitz. Okay, Horowitz later. But they really like this. Like, coming with diminuendo. But to make it easier for now, I mean to feel energetic crescendo, I suggest to make dynamical and energetic crescendo at the same time. Means if we're going to this interval, then allow yourself to naturally make a little crescendo. Not too much, but just don't suppress this feeling if you feel like doing this. And I also suggest to make extreme waves, meaning extreme back off in the beginning of the motif and extreme rising up the combination intervals. So you're gonna start very far away, and when you come, you really reach this interval. Later, everything will become more smoothly and natural in the perspective of full phrasing, but for now, try to sing and play, exaggerating every hill, every wave. Sing a motif with culminative interval C F sharp. You gather weight and sing with intonation and musical speech. It's very important, do not forget musical speech. Keeping in mind where you're heading, and natural, bringing more weight to the main interval. You don't think to bring like weight, but you will feel it, it's going to be natural. You have this like musical speech in your mind, and it's kind of easier to distribute, to know where you're going, like the second leads to third to fourth, and we're going to this triton. So do not sing without musical speech, do not start with full amount, okay, do not sing without musical speech means interval the same. Do not start with full amount of meaning and weight like this. Too close. Because you wouldn't feel, you know, space where you're going, you're already there. So you will start like pressing more. So always back off first. Better you back up, start from far away. Easier for you to make phrasing. Do not sing too slow. Because it's really hard to grasp, to embrace the motif in your mind. So make it small and short, so it will be like, bing, you got it in your mind. So. Play this motif while imagining it in sound, textures, movement, and alternating with weight. Take your time when you're coming to the main interval. Sometimes you might have to take more time, like slow down, to emphasize main interval. Whose culminative interval CC. Again, do the same, gather weight and sing with intonation, musical speech, keeping in mind where you're going, and naturally bring more weight to the main interval. Sing with musical speech, back off again, do not sing slow, and play this interval. And now we're going down. We're gonna sing this and come to C sharp. Next one is a phrase. Sing a phrase with culminative second motif. Gather weight and sing with intonation, musical speech, keep in mind where you're going, naturally bring more weight to the main motif, at the same time emphasizing main intervals in every motif. So even in less important motif, there is still its own culminative intervals inside. So second motif is more important. Okay. And let's play both hands, okay? I'm going to sing it one more time for you because it's harder. And now we are going to do sentence. So we're going to sing the whole sentence with culminative first phrase, and again bring everything to the first phrase, and at the same time emphasizing main motifs in every phrase. So when you sing, you want to sing it really, really fast to embrace the whole sentence. Okay. You see? And when you would sing like super slow, like, well, I still can feel it because I'm already master at this phrasing, but I'm not sure about you guys, the very first step, so always remind yourself, sing a little bit faster. Okay, now let's play. Inside the music. And lastly, to feel and embrace long line and melodies, only possible by seeing a clear structure of small blocks that are united in bigger blocks, and by feeling a steady energetic wave in every block. So if your teacher tells you, like, make a broader line, you know, feel the line of music. It's all very approximate, you cannot get the feeling. I mean, you can, but one day you can, another day you cannot. It's not really stable. So you can only see the whole big structure by seeing small structures that are united in bigger structures. So we can also say that the art of phrasing is the art of energetic waves. And so it has to be consistent by the structure. That means that we're choosing limits of motives, not being led by always changing melody patterns, but by bars. If we try to be oriented by melodies, for instance, end a motif with a longer note or with a rest, as you know, it's a common thing to do, the motif size would be always changed and there is no stability in energetic rhythm, and no correct building of phrases and sentences later on. No matter what, do not change the limits of motives. This is the most common question from my students because they're a little bit confused. Why am I connecting the size of motif to the bar? So this is the reason. Everything has to have a very clear structure to be able to build bigger structures on the bass on that. So, usually a motif lasts a bar and it always goes through the bar line. Not 1, 2, 3, 4, but 2, 3, 4, 1, or 3, 4, 1, 2, or 4, 1, 2, 3. And as you can feel, main intervals of motifs usually come to the first beat, like 2, 3, 4, 1, 3, 4, 1, 2, 4, 1, 2, 3. Usually a phrase lasts two motifs, main motifs are more expressive dynamically and melodically. You will feel like maybe sometimes it goes a little bit louder, or sometimes it's going higher, or sometimes composer uses longer notes in the main motif. And a sentence lasts two phrases. And main phrase is also more expressive dynamically and melodically and rhythmically.